Good morning, welcome back to our second class on continuity.
Since f of x is continuous at x equal to 1, therefore limit x tends to 1, f of x exists. This implies limit, that is left hand limit, x less than 1 must be equal to right hand limit when x is greater than 1. So when x is less than 1, our fx is x plus a. So we put x plus a here. And when it is bigger than 1, then we put twice x. So here. And now 1 plus a equal to 1, that means a equal to 1. Since f of x is continuous at x equal to pi by 2, therefore limit x tends to pi by 2 f of x must equal to f of pi by 2. This implies limit x tends to pi by 2 k cos x pi minus twice x equal to f of pi by 2, when x equal to pi by 2, f of x is 3, so we put 3 here. K is a constant we take outside of limit, and in place of cos x we write sin pi by 2 minus x. Here we take 2 common, this pi by 2 minus x equal to 3. Now k by 2, limit x tends to pi by 2 sin theta by theta equal to 3. We take let pi by 2 minus x equal to theta. When x tends to pi by 2, then theta tends to 0. So in place of x tends to pi by 2, we write theta tends to 0. This is implies k by 2 to 1 equal to 3, k equal to 6. Therefore, required k equal to 6. Let f and g are two continuous functions. Continuous function which are continuous at x equal to a. Therefore, limit x tends to a f of x must equal to f of x, and limit x tends to a g of x must be equal to g of x. Now we want to show that sum, that is f plus g, is also continuous at x equal to a. Now f plus g of x equal to f of x plus g of x. We take limit x tends to a f plus g of x equal to limit x tends to a f of x plus g of x. Now we separate the two limit. Limit x tends to a f of x here we find f of a and g of a. So we write here f of a plus g of a. This must be equal to f plus g of a. Therefore, limit x tends to a, f plus g of x equal to f plus g of a. Therefore, f plus g is continuous. Continuous at x equal to a. Therefore, sum of two continuous functions is also continuous. Similarly, if we take negative sign, then in place of plus sign we can put negative sign, and that is difference of two continuous functions is also continuous. Now, we want to show that product of two continuous functions is also continuous. We take limit x tends to a, f of g, fg of x, limit x tends to a, f of x, g of x. We separate into two limit. Limit x tends to a, f of x into limit x tends to a, g of x. This is limit, in place of this we write f of a g of a. This is f g of a. Therefore, limit x tends to a f of g also continuous. So we take limit x tends to a fg of x equal to limit x tends to a f of x into g of x. Limit x tends to a f of x into limit x tends to a g of x is equal to f of a g of a. This is equal to fg of a. Therefore, limit x tends to a fg of x equal to fg of a. Therefore, fg is continuous. Continuous at x equal to a. Similarly, we can show that divided. Now we take f plus g of x is equal to limit x tends to a f of x g of x. Now this is equal to limit x tends to a f of x by limit x tends to a g of x is f of a by g of a. This is f plus g of a. Therefore, f plus f by g is continuous at x equal to a provided g of a not equal to 0. That is, limit x tends to a g of x is non-zero. We consider the function f and g defined as f and G. G defined as f of x equal to x plus sine of 1 by x when x not equal to 0. This equal to 0 and x equal to 0. And g of x equal to x minus sine 1 by x when x not equal to 0. This equal to 0 and x equal to 0. Since limit x tends to 0 sine 1 by x does not exist, so f of x and g of x is not continuous at x equal to 0. Now, we take sum of f plus g of x equal to fx plus g of x. So this is twice x. Twice x is always continuous at x equal to 0. So, this is the example of function with both are f and g are both discontinuous, but their sum is continuous. Now we take another two function f and g. Defined as f of x equal to x, comma all x, g of x equal to sine 1 by x, x not equal to 0. Is equal to 0 when x equal to 0. Fx is continuous at x equal to 0, but g of x not continuous at x equal to 0. Now we take product fg of x equal to f of x g of x. This is equal to x sine of 1 by x. Since limit x tends to 0, x sine 1 by x equal to 0. Therefore, f of g is continuous at x equal to 0. F of x equal to mod x. Already we know that mod x equal to x when x greater than 0. Equal to 0 when x equal to 0. Equal to minus x when x less than 0. We want to discuss continuity of mod x. So we take, let c be any real number. First we take, let c equal to 0. So, f of 0 equal to, from here we find, f of 0 equal to 0. Next we find, limit x tends to 0, f of x. Already we know that f is continuous at x equal to 0. And here, we find left hand limit, the limit x tends to less than 0 f of x. It is equal to limit x tends to 0 in case of fx, we put minus x is 0. And also in right hand limit, limit x greater than 0 plus f of x. So when x is greater than 0, fx is x. So here is also. Therefore, left hand limit equal to right hand limit. Therefore, limit x tends to 0, f of x exists. And it's equal to limit x tends to 0, f of x equal to 0. Therefore, f is continuous. That is, mod x is continuous at x equal to 0. Or c equal to 0, m right, c equal to 0. Now, let c less than 0. We take c less than 0. C less than 0. Then, f of c equal to minus c. where x less than 0, fx is minus 1. So above c is minus 2. To find limit x tends to c f of x. Since c is less than 0, so fx is minus x. So we write this is minus c. Therefore, limit x tends to c f of x equal to f of c. Therefore, f is continuous at x less than or c less than 0. Now we take c greater than 0. C greater than 0. Then f of c equal to c. We will find limit x tends to c f of x. Since c is greater than 0, so in place of x we put f of x equal to x. And here is c. Here also limit x tends to c f of x must equal to f of c. Therefore f is continuous at c greater than 0. So f is continuous for every real number. Let f of x equal to sin x. Let c be any real number. Now limit x tends to c f of x equal to limit x tends to c sin x. Limit h tends to 0. We take that x equal to c plus h. Therefore, h tends to 0 as x tends to c. Sin of c plus h. We use the formula of sin a plus b. Sin c cos b plus cos a sin b. This is equal to separate into two limits. Limit h tends to 0, sin c cos h plus limit h tends to 0, cos c sin h. Sin c is constant term, so we take it outside of the limit, and limit h tends to 0, cos h plus cos c limit h tends to 0 sin h. This is sin c, this is cos h. Limit h tends to 0, cos h is 1, and sin limit h tends to 0, sin h is 0. So this is sin c. This is equal to f of c. Therefore, limit x tends to c f of x equal to f of c. Therefore, f is continuous at x equal to c for any real number. C is arbitrary point, so f is continuous for every real number.
Now we want to prove that the function f of x equal to 10x is continuous function. Let f of x equal to 10x, then already we know that 10x equal to sin x by cos x. We take sin x as a gx, g of x, and cos x as h of x. So f of x equal to g of x by h of x. Let c be any real number. Limit x tends to c g of x. Limit x tends to c sin of x. Already we know that sin x is continuous. We prove here sin x is continuous. Limit h tends to 0 sin of c plus h. Let c plus h equal to x. Therefore h tends to 0 as x tends to c. Now we write the formula of sin a plus b. Limit h tends to 0 sin c cos h plus cos c sin h. we take sin c outside of the limit, so sin c into limit h tends to 0 cos h plus cos c into limit h tends to 0 sin h equal to sin c into 1 plus cos c into 0 equal to sin c equal to g of c. Therefore, g of x is continuous at x equal to c. Now we take limit x tends to c h of x. Limit x tends to c cos x. Limit h tends to 0 cos of c plus h. Let c plus h equal to x. Therefore, h tends to 0 as x tends to c. Equal to limit h tends to 0 cos c cos h minus sin c sin h. Equal to cos c limit h tends to 0 cos h minus sin c limit h tends to 0 sin h. Equal to cos c into 1 minus sin c into 0 equal to cos c equal to h of c. Therefore, h is continuous at x equal to c. You should look at the cos x not equal to 0. This implies x not equal to twice n plus 1 into pi by 2. Therefore, limit x tends to c h of x not equal to 0. That's why h is continuous at x equal to c. Therefore, g by h is continuous at x equal to c. Therefore, f is continuous at x equal to c. That is, tan x is continuous function. Now we discuss discontinuity of a function. A function is said to be discontinuous at a point c if it is not continuous at c. Already we know that when a function is continuous, the point c is then called a point of discontinuity of the function. Types of discontinuities. Number one, removal discontinuity. A function f is said to have a removal discontinuity at x equal to a if limit x tends to a f of x is exist but not equal to the value of f of a. That is, limiting value and functional value are not equal. Then this discontinuity is called removal discontinuity. Number two, discontinuity of first kind. A function f is said to have a discontinuity of first kind at x equal to a if left hand limit and right hand limit both exist but are not equal. Number three, discontinuity of the second kind. A function f is said to have a discontinuity of the second kind at x equal to a if neither left hand limit nor right hand limit exist. Thank you.